Good morning, honorable co-chairs, esteemed colleagues, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the second meeting of the Joint Committee referred to as the QuadCom. Today, we gather to continue our investigation into the alarming and deeply rooted criminalities involving drugs, financial crimes, corruption, and human rights violations sponsored by a well-coordinated drug syndicate that has been operating in the country for years already. In the ongoing Committee on Dangerous Drugs investigation into the 3.6 billion Shabu seizure in Mexico, Pampanga, we discovered that the warehouse where the drug was found was owned by a company, Empire 999, controlled by Chinese nationals masquerading as Filipinos. It was identified that certain persons named Willie Ong and A.D. Tai Yang, who owned majority shares in the company, were Chinese nationals with fake Filipino identities. These individuals managed to put up the corporation and acquire vast land holdings worth billions of pesos across the country in circumvention of the constitutional limitation on land ownership. The well-organized syndicate floods the country with dangerous drugs in probable connivance with corrupt officials and employees of the government agencies and possibly local government officials. Drugs destroy societies. Its uncontrolled proliferation was the main culprit why thousands of our countrymen were allegedly executed without benefit of due process. To date, we are painstakingly putting the pieces together in the hope of giving justice to the victims. We are also hopeful that no more injustice of this kind will continue with the vigilance of our law enforcement teams who have so far hold in at least 34 billion pesos worth of illegal drugs within the first 2 years of the BBM administration. Bukod sa droga, ang sindikatong ito ay nakapagpapasok din ng bilyong-bilyong pera na galing sa masamang gawain na kanila namang ipinapasok sa mga casinos at pogos upang linisin at kunwari na panalunan sa kanilang sugal. Pag malinis na ang pera, ito ay ginagamit pambayad at pangsuhol sa mga taong gobyerno na siya naman gumagawa ng mga ilegal na pamamaraan upang bigyan ang mga dayuhang intsik na ito ng mga pekeng papeles upang makapagpanggap na sila ay mga Pilipino. Kapag may mga papeles na sila, na kunwari ay Pilipino na sila, at gamit ang nilinis na pera, gumagawa na sila ng mga korporasyon at namimili ng mga lupain at iba pang ari-arian na reserbado lamang po sa ating mga Pilipino. Hindi mangyayari ang lahat ng ito kung hindi tinutulungan at nakikipagsabwatan ang ibang kawani ng ating gobyerno at ibang kawani ng pamahalaang lokal upang mapasakamay ng mga dayuhan ang mga pag-aaring ito. As a result, drugs continue to flow into our country and pogos have become hubs for all manner of criminal activity including kidnapping, murder, human trafficking, prostitution, money laundering, investment scams, and other cyber crimes. Pogos introduced under the guise of generating the much-needed revenue have instead revealed themselves as a curse, becoming gateways for syndicate members to enter the country as legitimate visitors, investors, or even citizens. It is now the monumental task of this QuadCom or of this committee to build on the progress made by the individual committees, uniting our efforts to develop legislative solutions and support the prosecution of those involved in this criminal network. We are determined to leave no stone unturned in our quest to unmask these syndicates, expose their activities, and ensure that they are brought to justice. Together, we will continue this fight until we have fully uncovered the truth and can finally put an end to this menace. Magandang umaga sa ating lahat. Ang ating pong venue sa ngayong araw na ito ay dito po sa Bacolod, Pampanga. Dahil po ang komite ay naniniwala na dito sa Pampanga ay marami pong nabili na mga lupain itong mga sindikatong ito. As evidenced by the investigation that the committee has uncovered, marami pong lupain, hindi lamang po libo-libong square meters, kundi libo-libong ektarya po ang nabili. Dito rin po sa probinsya ng Pampanga, na-discover ang isang warehouse na naglalaman ng 560 kilos of shabu. At dito rin po, mga pogo na illegal na pogo na nag-operate dito sa ating bansa. So, I'd like to thank the local government of the province of Pampanga for hosting this first public joint committee hearing of the Quadcom. Maraming salamat po kay Honorable Mayor Eduardo Datu, Honorable Vice Mayor Ron Irvin Dunca, Honorable Councilor Angelina Angeles, Honorable Councilor Joel Samia, Honorable Councilor Isa May Cunanan, Honorable Councilor Carlito Laksa, Honorable Councilor Joe Derek Gizon,